Let us look at the character functions first. The first function that we have is length. This function will return the length of a given string. So length morning from dual. Now see guys, we are using the dual table. Remember the dual table, it's only used when you are using your own expressions or you want to check your own data. Of course, you can run this kind of character function on table as well. Like in our next function, we'll be running the query against the table. So let us run this one and see what is the output. So we are using the length function to identify the length of this word morning. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 should be the output, and let us look at the output, and the output is 7. Perfect. And what's next? Concat. We want to add or concatenate two strings. So what we are doing is select concat. Remember guys, in SQL there are two concatenation functions. One is the concat function itself and also the double pipe symbol that we had seen earlier. So don't get confused, both are one and the same. So now we want to concatenate the last name and salary, and over here we are using output column name alias name and salary from hr.employees, right? So let us run this query. So now we got the name and salary concatenated. Now assume that you want to give a space in between. So how will you do it? So after last name, give comma, and then give a single quote, space, again give a single quote, and then we'll run this query. Okay, it says invalid operator. So I think concatenation operator or function takes double quotes. So let me run this one and then see. Oh, it does not take. Okay, I think this concatenate function won't take the space operator, but the pipe symbol. Remember when we were working on the pipe symbol, we did give a space in our output. So looks like this concatenation function does not take a space, right? And this is your output column name alias. We had already seen it, so I'm not going in depth into it. Next is initcap. Initcap function is simple, capitalizes the initial letters of given string. Now this is the string where the initial letters are in lower case. Let us run this query and then see what's the output. We'll run it. Can you see? The initial letter is capitalized and all other letters are in lower case. That is initcap. That means initial letter will be capitalized and all others will be moved into the lower case. Next is lower. Very simple, converts a string into the lower case. So over here we have a string good morning in uppercase. Let us see what is the output. Select lower good morning from dual. So our output is all small case. Upper will convert your string into uppercase. Now we have the output or the we have the string in lowercase, good morning, and we want to convert it into uppercase. Let us run this query. Can you see all the entire string is converted into uppercase. Lpad. Lpad is nothing but it's left pad, the given character for the given width. So with on the left side of this word or the string called good, we want to add 10 times dollar sign. So let me run this one, then it will make little sense. Okay. So this 10 is the total length after adding the dollar. Okay, it's not like $10 will be added, it's the total length. Now within this string GOOD, we have four characters. So 6 dollar signs have been added on the left side because we are using the function called as lpad. And you can see the column Elia's name, we are using lpad example. So the output column name is also lpad example. The same goes with rpad. So I'm just skipping it. It will add the dollar sign onto the right side rather than onto the left side. Substir, it will actually extract a substring from a given string. Okay, so select substir good morning, the starting position, like from this string, the starting position is 6th and the number of characters. That means from the 6th position, extract 4 characters. Okay, so let us try to run this query. I know guys, some of you might be getting bored, but once you start working with these functions and queries, and when you see real-time output, you actually try to enjoy these SQL queries. Now you can see from the 6th position, what is the 6th position? This is 1, 2, 3, 4, and then we have a space. Space is also counted as 1, okay, 5. So the 6th position is M. So from the 6th character, we have to extract 4 characters. 1, 2, 3, 4, M-O-R-N. That's our perfect output. So substring or substir, that's the function that you use to extract a substring from a given string. Ltrim removes some characters from the left of a given string. See, select ltrim, Scott, and then we specify S. So what it will do is it will remove the character S from the left of the given string. So let us run this query. We are trying to remove the first character, that is S, out of the given string Scott, right? So our output is C-O-T-T, cot. The same goes with rtrim. It will remove the character from the right side of the given string from the John, and we are removing the character E, right? So this will be removed from the character because it's on to the right side. The next function that we have is instir. Searches given second string into the given first string. So we have a complete string and then the substring that we want to search in the first string. Later on, we can even define the starting position and the nth appearance of the substring that we want to search in the main string. So how does it work? See, instir, this is tech on the net. This is our main string. And then we want to search E. That's the alphabet we want to search, or that's the character we want to search under instir. So what happens is, by default, if you do not give the starting position, it will start from the first or the first character within the given string. So the result is 2. That means this E character appears under the second position in the given string, right? So if you don't specify the start position, it will by default search from the starting of the given string. Now in the next example, so it's nothing but the same example, but we are also specifying the starting position and the nth appearance. Okay, so in this case, if you see instir tech on the net, we want to search E inside tech on the net, and we want to start it from the position 1, and we want the first appearance as it appears in the output, right? So nothing but if you see, we have substituted the starting position and the nth appearance. So guys, in any syntax of a query, if you see these brackets, that means this value is optional. But if you see string and substring, there are no brackets like this. That means you have to give these two values. But these two values, starting position and nth appearance, these are optional. So if you don't provide, by default it will be 1, 1. Now let us look at this example. In this example, instead tech on the net E, we want to start from the position 1, but we need the second appearance. We don't want the first appearance of the character E. So what happens is the result will be 11, because on the 11th position we have the second E. Can you see the output? The second occurrence of the character E. Now in this case, instead tech on the net, okay, and then we want to the same character E, we want to start from the position 1, but we need the third occurrence of the character. Now this might be tricky. In the entire string you have only 2 E, correct? So what happens is the instead will continue to read or continue to check for the occurrence of E again from the starting of the string. So how does it work? See, first occurrence 1, 2. On the second position we have the first occurrence, but we need the third occurrence. So what happens? This is skipped. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Okay. Oh, I think in the last one we missed this E. I'm sorry, my mistake. Yeah. So over here the third appearance is already there in the net, right? So this will be the output. Sorry guys, I missed the E in this word, THED. So that's why I was a little confused. So the instead will give you the third occurrence of the character E. So it won't start again from the beginning of the given string. Okay, please ignore it. And this one, instead tech on the net E, it says we want to start from the -3 position. So what is the -3 position? This is the start position, right? So -3 means from the end you go 3 characters, 1, 2, and 3. Okay, so this is the exact starting point, and from there it says the second appearance. So how will you get the output? So now the instead function will start at n, so 1, 2, on the -2 position. Let me write it down for you guys. See, this is -3, the n will be -3, right? N is at -3, so E is at -2, and T is at -1. That's the positions, correct? So -3 means from the end you will be going 3 characters back. So the starting position is N. The first appearance is at -2, but we need the second appearance. So what happens is it will complete this string and then it starts again from the first. So T and then E. So T is the first position and E is on the second position. So you will get the result as 2. I know guys, it's tricky, but if you run these queries couple of times, then you will understand how they work. And the final character function that we have is replace. It's very simple. Replace all occurrences of search term inside another string. So if you have a search term and it will replace the output value with whatever you specify. Like in this string we have 9, because it's very simple, right? So 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, -3. Can you see we have 9 3 times? So the search term is 9. What we are doing is we are using the replace function and we are replacing the number 9 with 85. So what will be the output? So the output will be, for the first 9 it will substitute as 85, so it will be 85. For the second 9 it will substitute as 85. For the third 9 it will substitute as 85, and finally we have 7. So this will be the output. Let us run this query and then see the output. because it will replace all the occurrences of the number 9 with 85. The same goes with, let's take you want to replace the December with November. So, but in our case, we are currently under November month. So I'll replace the November with December and then see the output. Now, can you see it's the same exact output that we already calculated, right? Now, let us run this command, or rather first I'll run this command without the function. Select sysdate from dual and let me run this one. So 18 November 18, right? And now select replace sysdate, and I want to replace November with December from dual. And let us run this query. Now it's nothing but 18 December 18. Perfect. So guys, these are the built-in character functions that you have. I want you to personally execute them, play with them as much as possible until you by heart or you remember them without even looking at the notes. Trust me, these are very important in real time.